In the freshly concluded Dokolo district by-election that highlighted participation of the country's top political parties, the Uganda People's Congress Party candidate Sara Aguti emerged winner out of the six official candidates.
As a returning officer for Dokolo, electoral district, and in accordance with Section 53 of the Parliamentary Elections Act, Deklaria Aguti Sara, who has obtained the largest number of votes, winner and district woman representative of Parliament, Dokolo
NRM and FDC party candidates Janet Rose Elau and Rosemary Alwatch followed suit in the second and third positions with 14,001 votes and 8,168 votes, respectively. Nevertheless, the FDC party has attached their party's loss to propagandist elements during the electoral time.
We congratulate the UPC candidate, the Honorable Sara Aguti Nyangakoli, for winning this fiercely contested election. We may not have won primarily due to the malicious propaganda against her, our candidate, and other various factors which we will thoroughly analyze for future reference. We commend Dr. Rosemary Ogwal for carrying the FDC flag high during this by-election.
The FDC has further identified gaps in last week's cabinet reshuffle, emphasizing that some of the ministers shouldn't have resurfaced. On the other side of the coin, the party suggests a reduction of ministers in a bid to not only minimize corruption, but also reduce the tax burden.
It is our considered opinion as FDC that we have a bloated cabinet, a cabinet of over 80 ministers. We think it is a burden to the taxpayers, because even if I can put a question on you journalists who are very observant, you may fail to mention the names, the 80 names of the ministers we have. Even if ministers line up here, you may fail to even trace this one is who, this one is this.
Last week, President Yoweri Museveni made several changes in his cabinet and within the army, including the appointment of General Muhoozi Kainerugaba as the Chief of Defence Force and relocating General Mbasumbadi from the helm of UPDF to the Ministry of Trade. Against this context, FDC has lashed out at their Katonga faction counterparts on allegations that there was a collusion between FDC and the NRM.
Cabinet reshuffle dispels the false narrative propagated by our colleagues at Katonga that the FDC leadership colluded with NRM. The absence of any appointed FDC official in the cabinet reaffirms that our party has no cooperation agreement or business with NRM.
The party climaxed by imploring all Ugandans, regardless of their religious affiliations, to utilize this fasting period as an opportunity to earnestly pray to the Almighty for an end to the nation's grievances like endemic corruption, poverty, land grabbing, and other pressing challenges. Meanwhile, the National Economic Empowerment Dialogue Party has based the recent appointment of General Muhoozi on universal adult suffrage predicaments for his win if he were to stand for presidency in the 2026 election.
There was a disagreement between the president and the people who were around his son mostly on how Muhoozi was going to be president. Now, the people who were around his son were convincing him that they can popularize him enough for him to win an election through universal adult suffrage, the way elections have been. But Museveni has so many weaknesses, but being delusional is not one of them. So he knew that there is no way his son was going to win an election. But then he has a better way of making, he has in his mind a better way of making him president.
Kabuleta remarked that even though the opposition longs to take over power from the current regime, one fact is inevitable and has to be dealt with first to solve the opposition's internal political rifts.
We want to rebuild our country away from Museveni. And now, because we want that, and because we have been kind of struggling towards that right now, but now is the most important time, because now is the time of transition. The transition is going to happen one way or the other. So now is the time for all the forces of change to come together and stop hitting at each other, stop, tearing each other apart.
Derek Asaba reporting for the news.